Hello and welcome to this video session on PIC microcontroller features and architecture. So we will be talking about the PIC microcontroller 16F877a. So these are the learning outcomes for this video session. A student after completion of session will be able to enlist the features which we'll be discussing, and then we'll be able to identify how this particular PIC microcontroller will be suitable for various applications. So when you are doing some application, whether this PIC will be suitable or which chip is to be used. And also student will be able to describe the architecture of the PIC microcontroller, and in detail we will be discussing the block diagram also. So these are the contents of the presentation. We will be talking about the introduction, then high performance features, peripheral features, analog features, and some special microcontroller features we will be discussing. And at the end, we will be talking about the architecture of the PIC microcontroller. Also, we will go through the block diagram for the PIC microcontroller 16F877A. Now talking about the high performance features, as I said, this microcontroller is having various features. With this, it starts with the RISC CPU. RISC stands for Reduced Instruction Set Computer. So this has a RISC CPU, and hence you'll find that only 35 instructions are there. Also, almost all the instructions are single cycle instructions. Hence, we can have the parallel pipelining we can have. And then there are few instructions where we are using jump or call, and these are two machine cycle instructions. Then talking about the operating speed, it operates on the clock. It can operate on the clock of 20 megahertz. Also, in one machine cycle, there are four clock cycles. So 20 megahertz clock connected will result into 4 megahertz machine cycle frequency. And hence, if it is a 4 megahertz machine cycle frequency, reciprocal of that will result into 200 nanosecond instruction cycle. It means it will take 200 nanoseconds for execution of a single machine cycle instruction. Then it has got memory. So talking about the memory, three different types of memories are there. Flash memory, it has 8 kilobytes into 14. So 8 kilo address locations are there. At every location, you can store 14 bit data. And then you have RAM memory, data memory, which is RAM. So 368 bytes of RAM we have. Again, it is divided into four different banks. Along with the program memory, flash program memory, and data memory, here we have got the E square PROM data memory also, which is 256 by 8, and this IC is compatible with the 28 pin or 40 or 44 pin PIC microcontroller series microcontrollers. Now talking about the peripheral features, so as we know that the feature of the microcontroller as compared to microprocessor is so many peripheral features, peripheral hardware is available inside the chip itself. So let us look at what are the peripheral features this microcontroller has. So it has got timers. Three timers are there: timer 0, timer 1, timer 2. You'll find some additional facility here. That timer has got something called as pre-scalar, or here you'll find that this timer has got pre-scalar as well as post-scalar also. So 8-bit timer, timer 0 is there, 16-bit timer, timer 1 is there, and timer 2 is also there, which has got pre-scalar as well as post-scalar. So the key role played by this pre-scalar and post-scalar facility is you can extend the delay for overflow of the timer. You know that the timer size will decide how much time it will take to overflow. So you cannot increase if you want to have higher delays. It's not like just go on increasing the size of the timer register. Instead of that, you may go for different pre-scalar and post-scalar options available to this PIC microcontroller timer. Along with the timer, it has got one feature called as CCP. It's capture, compare, and PW module. So capture module is 16-bit, and compare module is also 16-bit. And here basically what happens in capture, compare is there is timer register, and then capture registers are there, then CCP registers are there. So timer register value may get stored in the CCP register when you are using capture. Here some timer register value is compared, and then when the result is there, that result may be reflected onto the pin. Here pin may decide when to capture the contents of timer in case of capture mode. In compare mode, comparison is done between timer value and CCP register, and then when there is a match between these two, a signal may be generated onto the pin also. As well, it may generate the interrupt. And also it has a PWM module, which may be used for speed control of motor. You can generate PWM signal with different duty cycle also. Now, continuing with the peripheral feature, it supports the communication, serial communication as well parallel communication is supported. So synchronous serial port, it has got MSSP module, master synchronous serial port module, which supports two protocols. One is SPI and another is I2C. Along with this MSSP, it supports USART module, USART, and universal synchronous asynchronous reception transmission is possible through this PIC microcontroller. Not only serial, this parallel communication is also possible through this particular microcontroller. Along with this, it has got brownout detection. So supply voltage, if it is reduced below some threshold value, so that is brownout voltage, and then that has to be detected, and then it should result into the brownout reset. So this feature is also available in the PIC microcontroller. Now talking about the analog features, so not only digital features you have for the serial communication, parallel communication, it has, or that CCP module, it has got analog features, like it has inbuilt ADC. So this microcontroller has got inbuilt ADC. It's a 10-bit ADC, and 8 channels are there. 8 different sensors or analog input can be connected to the microcontroller, and its digital conversion can be done one at a time, and that conversion can be of 10 bits. So 10 bit conversion, 10 bit resolution you can get by using this particular microcontroller. It has got a facility of brownout reset. Then it has got analog comparators also. Two analog comparators are there, and for that you can have you require some reference voltage, so that reference voltage is also programmable, and then comparator outputs are also accessible externally onto the pins. These are some of the analog features. So now let us talk about some special features of this microcontroller. So it has got around 1 lakh times erase write cycle, means you can have flash programming erase and write cycle for 1 lakh times. Not only that, 10 lakh times what you can do is you can have that erase write cycle for the E square prom, electrically erasable programmable read only memory typically. Then it has got memory retention of the data from the memory, this E square prom retention is more than 40 years. Then self programming is possible, ICT in circuit serial programming is possible. So no need to remove the controller and then move it to the programmer, program it again, mount it onto the your board. No, not necessary. You can go for that in circuit serial programming feature. Then it has got one very powerful feature and useful feature called as watchdog timer, which may be used to prevent the program going into the infinite loop. So you can have code protection also, you can have programmable code protection. Then sleep mode is there for power saving purpose. Oscillator selection means there are different oscillator selection options available. You can select RC oscillator, then external oscillator selection options are available. So it is selectable oscillator option. And then in circuit debugging via two pins is also possible. Now this is in brief architecture of the PIC microcontroller. So what you find in this particular PIC microcontroller architecture is you have got a CPU which can work with the 35 instructions. Then oscillator is required, internal oscillator is also available, and ADC is there. Reference voltage for the comparator which is required is available, as well CCP module, PWM module. Ports are there, 5 different ports you are finding here, port A, B, C, D, E. And then it supports interrupt, watchdog timer, as well the reset circuit is there. And talking about the memories, these are the different types of memories, program memory, E square prom memory, RAM. Let us look at this architecture in somewhat detail. So let us talk about the block diagram of PIC microcontroller. So what you are finding, basically what you are finding on this side is, these are the port pins of the microcontroller, 5 ports are there. And if you see, most of the port pins are multifunctional. So more than 2 or 3 functions are assigned to the same pin. This has to do with so many peripherals are there. And then if you do multiplexing, so total number of pins will be reduced if you do the multiplexing. So if you find here, if you look at here, you have got a flash program memory, and here you have got the data memory. So as I said, there are advantages of going for the Harvard architecture. So what architecture is there for PIC microcontroller? You are finding program memory and data memory is separate. Hence, it is nothing but a Harvard architecture. As well, if you look at this program memory, what is the size of the program memory we have seen? It supports program memory of 8K into 14. So here you have 8K different locations. Now, to access these 8K locations, you should specify the address of the instruction. So you know that standard register called as program counter register is always pointing to the instruction location. So if you have 8K locations, to address these 8K locations, you will require 13-bit address. So you find here 13-bit address is there. So that is available always in the program counter register. Now, one interesting thing here, you are finding something written is stack memory. So in case of PIC microcontroller, this stack memory is neither part of program memory or data memory. It is an 8-level hardware stack. Fine. So now you find that this program memory, it has program, opcodes are there. Every opcode will be of 14 bits, so that opcode goes to the instruction register. Now you can find that when it goes to the instruction register, either that instruction may be directly given to the instruction decoder. When it goes to the instruction decoder, what it does is it decides what timings and signals is to be generated. And then when you want to execute, basically the instructions are getting executed here at ALU level. And then for the instruction, operands are required. So most of the times, operands, one of the operand is usually available in one register called as W register. It's like an accumulator register of microcontroller 8051. So W register is there. And then as it supports three addressing modes, immediate addressing, direct addressing, and indirect addressing, you will find that if it is immediate addressing, opcode or that instruction opcode itself has the operand available. So that will be directly taken and made available for ALU. If it is a direct addressing, then direct address is available. And that 7-bit address you're finding here in the instruction itself, then remaining 2 bits are taken from the special function register called as status register for direct addressing, and then it can point to any of the memory location inside the data memory, and that will be available to you as a operand if it is a direct addressing. If it is indirect addressing, then FSR is one register used for indirect addressing. Along with this FSR, one more register INDF is used, and then through indirect addressing also you can have access to the operand. So you can have one or more operands. One may be available in working register, another may be through instruction itself, or directly by using direct addressing it may be made available, or through indirect addressing it will be made available to the ALU. ALU will run that particular code, and whatever is the result may be available in the working register, or it can be directly stored into the file register also. And then other features are like, these are some timing features. Timers are available, watchdog timer, then power down mode. So power down timer is available. Then this is the reset signal available, power supply signals, as it has timers, timer 0, timer 1, timer 2. So these timers are shown. Internal data square prom is there. CCP module, as we have discussed in the feature, CCP module is available. It supports serial communications, USART module as well. It supports parallel communications. So PSP module is also available here. And remaining things are the port pins. So this is in general architecture of the block diagram of the PIC microcontroller, where you find that it is having Harvard architecture, it supports direct, indirect, and immediate addressing as well. It has got these very useful peripheral features. So these are the references used for this presentation. Thank you.